हाय बलराम। बस हेलो मैम,
हाय शिवांगी, आई
हाउ आर यू मैम? गुड इवनिंग।
एम गुड। हाउ आर यू? यू आर सो ब्यूटीफुल।
नो, आई एम नॉट मोर देन यू।
यू आर अ ब्यूटीफुल गर्ल एंड योर ब्यूटीफुल स्माइल।
थैंक यू मैम फॉर द कॉम्प्लीमेंट। सो एनी इंश्योर
एम आई
प्रोवाइड जो एनी?
ऑडिबल? एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस मैम। Maybe I think some internet disruption is there. Minor one.
Shall I put on the speaker? I think I'll put on the speaker.
Yeah, maybe.
External speaker, so that
Yeah.
you are also, your questions are clear, right?
Yeah, ma'am.
Yeah, can you just
Otherwise, your
repeat?
voice is. Yeah, hello. Am I audible?
Is not connecting. Why?
Okay. But otherwise, your voice is all fine. I can clearly hear your voice.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
yeah,
Fine.
yeah.
Fine. So we can start.
Yeah. Okay. So basically, before starting, I would let everybody knows about you. A small introduction by me. So, ma'am is Lieutenant Colonel Ankita Srivastav, who has given service for the nation about 14 years in Indian Army. And the important thing about her is that she is one of the women who was in the batch when the women cadets have gone the permanent commission. And overall, it was a third batch of OTA Chennai. And otherwise, she is a superb writer. I have read so many of those while searching about you, also about your books you have authored. And apart from that, she has also won some beauty pageants. So we'll be more discussing about that. And the main attraction for this show would be, you know, your hobbies, your passion towards new things. You always try like to try new things, whichever you have never learned. So that one of that is dancing, and so all that will be considered here. So yeah, that was all about ma'am. You have anything, ma'am, to say before I proceed with my
I
question?
I have to say, I have to first appreciate
Okay.
you. I have to appreciate your name is Shivangi. Huh?
Yes,
so Rolling Stone, that was that's your ID, and that came as such a big surprise to me. I have been putting up my reels. In fact, one of the Insta follower only taught me how to make a reel. I was totally new to this concept, and I did that because it was motivating me to do more and more. And hats off to you, Shivangi. You spotted me, and very sweetly you approached me. I was like too thrilled to. I'd never thought that for dance I will be approached or I will be asked a question about dancing skill, which is not a skill actually. But then I have been just trying because, as I found, dancing is another challenge kind of a thing. Basically, I love to do something which disciplines me. So I'm a very disciplined person. I'm a very disciplined person. Even at the age of 52 today, I'm a very disciplined person. So discipline leads you to success. I have always believed in this. So I thought dancing is again a form of discipline because I synchronize my movements, my expressions with the lyrics of the singer, actually. So I'm putting myself out of my comfort zone, forcing myself to match everything with that of the singer. So this is kind of a
That I have noticed. Important thing about because that was the important thing I noticed about your dance. Like, you have chosen some old songs, but you have noted all the lyrics and you try to express, like, put expression. And I think that also you are trying to learn, because I have read also in caption that you're trying to put more of expression. Because while I was navigating through internet about you, I found that you were a kind of a tomboy in your early childhood days. So how come you like started from a very, you know, a rigorous woman who was in Indian Army, who has trained into different terrain, like in different difficult situation, now coming to a delicate profession, or maybe, you know, something which is which requires some delicacy, or maybe I would say that kind of thing. So how come you like transformed from there?
Yeah, see, Army is again a very disciplined organization, and 14 years in the army as the initial batches of lady officer. I was the first from Allahabad to join Indian Army. Yes. And it actually did not want lady officer. That time it was very difficult to prove that you are not a lady officer. So army wanted that I should not behave like a girl. I should not behave, do anything like a girl. I should behave like an officer. An officer in those days meant a man, actually a man. So what I did, I almost converted myself into a masculine figure in my unit, in my first unit. Very, very short hair, chopped hair, shorter than yours actually. And wearing uniform, walking in a very manly manner, talking in a manly manner, because I had to address and command men in uniform. They were double my age. And I had to put up an example that I am very disciplined and very capable of leading them in the times of war also, if need be. So I had to put up a great degree of discipline in front of them. And in that, I lost my complete femininity. मैं धीरे धीरे पता नहीं कब वो लड़की से महिला नहीं बनी, मैं लड़की से सीधे पुरुष बन गई. बीच में वो महिला वाला स्टेज मेरी लाइफ में आया ही नहीं कभी. सो आई वाज नेवर अ वुमन, आई वाज नेवर अ वुमन, आई वाज फ्रॉम स्ट्रेट फ्रॉम गर्ल टू अ मैन एक्चुअली. एंड इट कंटिन्यूड फॉर 14 लॉन्ग इयर्स, वेयरिंग माई ड्रिल बूट्स, वेयरिंग माई यूनिफॉर्म, द वे आई टॉक, द वे आई बिहेव, एवरीथिंग वॉज वेरी वेरी मैस्कुलीन. And once I left army, I did not leave army because those days permanent commission had not come. So I had to come home. I realized ki abhi main ekdam aadmi jaisi ho gayi hu, mujhe civil mein koi accept hi nahi kar raha hai. You know, I was like so masculine. Everybody used to wonder ye kaun si cheez hai, hai to ye mahila baat karti hai purushon jaisi. So it was very difficult for me to adjust. Then I decided I have to learn first how to be a woman. तो woman बनने की जो मैंने मुहिम चालू करी, that was the beauty pageant. मुझे लगा that is the only place where I will learn what is the difference between an eyeliner and a lip liner. I did not.
Okay.
मुझे नहीं पता था. मेरे लिए सब ग्रीक था, सब कुछ एकदम पता ही नहीं था ये होता क्या है. I had no idea what a makeup is. I had never worn makeup in my life. And I was 38. Mind you, I was not chota. Main 38 umar ki thi us waqt jab maine beauty pageant mein gayi. By the time of 39, I was there in Gladrex Mrs. India. So wahan jaake maine dekha kaise ek mahila banna hai. I learned how to stand like so dainty, so delicate. I was not delicate. I was like, every time, bum, boom, everything was so... Nothing was delicate about me. Even my voice was not delicate. It's still not. So, because I have given so many commands to the men, I have lost my soft voice actually. So there I learned the art of makeup, the art of standing like a woman, talking like a woman, dressing up like a woman beautifully. I mean, I was a woman, born as a woman, but then, yes, I have forgotten how to be a woman actually. वहां से मेरी एक जर्नी शुरू हुई अलग टाइप की. पिछले 12 साल से मैं ये कर रही हूँ. फिर मुझे लगा डांस एक अगेन बहुत ही प्यारा एक्सप्रेशन है अपने वुमनहुड को एक्सप्लोर करने का, अपने वुमनहुड को एंजॉय करने का. सो आई थॉट लेट मी डू डांस, लेट मी टेक दिस चैलेंज. अब इस उम्र में, उम्र के इस पड़ाव में मैं किसी डांस क्लास में तो जा नहीं सकती सीखने. सो लॉकडाउन केम. No, I've got so many things, other things to do. I'm a writer, I'm a mother, I'm a homemaker, I'm an officer. There's so many things. I have to drive. There are so many things. I cannot spend that much of time also. So, but I did go. मैं गुजरात में एक डांस क्लास अटेंड करने गई और मेरे से आधे उम्र का बच्चे ने मुझे सिखाने की बहुत कोशिश करी. मुझे नहीं समझ आया बिल्कुल. मैं नहीं सीख पाई. इवन गरबा आई कुडंट डू. I couldn't do garba. I was posted there last year. I couldn't do. मैं बस ऐसे देख के चली आई. मेरे को कुछ समझ नहीं आया. So these are my flaws, my inabilities हैं, but then I don't give up. I don't give up. ठीक है, है तो है. I will learn to overcome my flaws or जो inabilities हैं. So lockdown came as a big, big help to me. अभी lockdown में, that too in my quarantine, एंड बोथ माय ग्रोन अप सन्स नॉट टॉकिंग टू मी बिकॉज उनको तो कोई मतलब नहीं है, उनके पास कोई किस्से नहीं है, उनको बोलना है मम्मा भाग जाओ उस कमरे से, भागो भागो यहाँ से, मेरे को क्यों आ गए डिस्टर्ब करने. सो आई थॉट मैं करूँ क्या, आई नीड समथिंग इंटरेस्टिंग टू डू, बाहर जा नहीं सकते हो. So that is the time I thought, let me self-tutor myself in a dance skill. And मेरी मम्मी को बहुत शौक था डांस देखने का और करने का, तो उन्होंने मेरे को बोला क्या तुम मेरे लिए कोई पुराने गाने पे कर सकते हो. तो उनका फेवरेट गाना था, मतलब गाना है उनका, एक संजीव कुमार का है, फिरकी वाली तू कल फिर मत, कल फिर आना. Have you heard the song?
Yeah, I heard.
पुराना सॉन्ग है फिरकी वाली तू कल फिर आना. सो आई चोज दैट सॉन्ग एज माय फर्स्ट डांस. अब उसमें कोई डांस तो था नहीं, मैंने वो मूवी में देखा तो कोई डांस तो था नहीं. आई मीन आई वाज एक्चुअली कॉपिंग संजीव कुमार स्टेप्स बेसिकली. मैं मुझे वो कहीं महिला वाला मेरे अंदर अभी भी वो छुपा हुआ पुरुष है, इट कम्स आउट ऐसे ऐसे. आई डोंट हैव अ कंप्लीट वुमन. I am a woman exteriorly, but then I have that manliness still inside me. So I generally copy Amitabh Bachchan ke steps or Sanjeev Kumar ke steps. I will copy all the masculine steps very easily actually. So that is the song I performed, first song, and it became a huge hit. People liked it and people taught me also how to put in my expressions, how to put in my steps. They were all giving me critical reviews. जब मैं एक्सप्रेशन पे काम करती थी तो स्टेप रुक जाते थे, स्टेप काम करती थी तो एक्सप्रेशन बंद हो जाते थे. सो इट वाज अ वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर मी टू अंडरस्टैंड द सिमेट्री इन बिटवीन सिंक में लाना. बट देन टुडे आई कैन
लाइक यू सेड दैट, लाइक यू सेड यू ट्राई लाइक डिसिप्लिन इन एवरीथिंग. सो मे बी फॉर डांस ऑल्सो आपने एक बार सोचा कि उस चीज को बहुत एक परफेक्ट तरीके से आप करना चाह रहे थे, इसलिए आपको चीजें समझ नहीं आ रही थी इनिशियली.
एग्जैक्टली. हाँ, फिर मैंने कर लिया. अभी आप मुझसे क्लासिकल भी कराओगे वो भी मैं कर लूंगी. नाउ आई प्लान टू डू इट ऑन अ स्टेज आल्सो. सी लाइफ में एक चीज और है, डिसिप्लिन के अलावा कॉन्फिडेंस. यू शुड हैव दैट कॉन्फिडेंस टू परफॉर्म, नॉट ओनली परफॉर्म, इतना कॉन्फिडेंस होना चाहिए कि आप अपनी कमियों को भी पब्लिक के सामने लाने में शर्म नहीं फील करते हो. यू डोंट फील शाय ऑफ शोइंग दैट यू डोंट नो दिस. आई एम वेरी हैप्पी टू से आई डोंट नो दिस, आई डोंट नो. But then I'm trying. I will learn, and one day I will be performing on the stage. So that confidence is required.
Okay. So during army days, you never had such a stage performance on anything. Like maybe I have seen. I think for singing you have done. I'm not sure. I have seen a picture of yours having holding a mic. I'm not sure it was of singing or.
That was a husband's night. I was doing it in my husband's unit as a wife.
Okay.
I was just the host, MC, not a dance, not any dance.
Okay.
But I was supposed to dress up in a bridal attire.
I think your voice is breaking.
Just a minute. I think the battery. Is it okay?
Still it's reconnected. Yeah, I think it's fine now.
No?
Yeah, it's fine.
Is it okay
no,
now?
It's fine.
Yes. So, yeah, see, as an Air Force officer's wife, I'm an Air Force officer's wife as well. So, as a wife, you have to play multiple roles in the social circle. So, there I used to try to copy or learn from other ladies how to dress up again. But then, I could manage. But in the army, I have not done anything.
Okay. So I had some interesting thing. Okay, like just now you mentioned you were an army Air Force wife. So like recently there's a clash going between army and Air Force. So what is your opinion at your personal level? Like, was there anything related to some army and some Air Force?
You want to know what? There are so many episodes in my life actually.
Like basically in your personal life, since you belong to army and your husband belonged to Air Force, so was there something like this is superior or something like that?
Oh,
the current clash which is going on.
For that you are, okay, we keep on fighting. For that you have to read my humor in and out of uniform. I write that also. Soon a book will be coming out on that. I've written many of them. उसमें यू विल सी हाउ वी कीप ऑन फाइटिंग. इनफैक्ट ड्यूरिंग द लड़की दिखाना, इट्स एन अरेंज मैरिज, ड्यूरिंग द लड़की दिखाना सेरेमनी इन लखनऊ, तो हमारी पहली बात हुई थी, ही आस्क्ड मी अ क्वेश्चन, व्हिच इज योर यूनिट. सो आई सेड FOD, FOD, 5 FOD. सो ही मेड अ वेरी डर्टी फेस. ही सेड FOD? आई सेड या FOD. ही सेड FOD? आई सेड या FOD. सो ही सेज कि डू यू इवन नो व्हाट इज FOD इन एयर फोर्स? आई सेड आई डोंट नो, व्हाट इज इट, टेल मी. आई नो इन द आर्मी इट इज फील्ड ऑर्डनेंस डेपो. And that is the place I am posted. So he said, in Air Force, it is not a good word. It is called foreign object damage. It damages the aircraft. So, हमारी लड़ाई वहीं से शुरू हो गई थी. जब तक he was explaining, मैंने गुस्से में सारी काजू कतली खा ली. मैंने कहा ये लड़का तो बहुत ही ज़्यादा मेरे को down कर रहा है. ये Air Force वाला क्या समझता है अपने को? अभी मैं दिखाती हूँ आदमी ज़्यादा superior है. So I ate all the काजू कतलीस, kept फॉर द लड़का वाला, उनको आज तक मिली काजू कतली, मैं ही खा गई सारी. तो वी कीप फाइटिंग ऑन दिस थिंग,
काजू कतली वाला.
या काजू कतली,
आई थिंक आपने ये जो एनेक्डोट बोला, ये शायद डिफरेंट ट्रुथ्स करके ये वेबसाइट है, वेयर दिस शॉर्ट स्टोरीज, बिकॉज़ आई थिंक आई हैव गॉन थ्रू दिस वेबसाइट बिफोर. आई एम नॉट श्योर, but there's somewhere I've read this.
I'll send you the link. I'll let you see that. It is, I have written lots and lots. People have suggested me to convert it into a book, but mere dimag mein baithe baithe aata hai, main fatak se likh deti hu, dal deti hu. To
aapne already like three books likhi hui hain. You have already written three books.
One book is the Pink Scarecrow. One is that is a military romantic suspense fictional story. Then I have written a book of poems that is Essas, and then 15 anthologies wherein I have put in one of my stories and poems, lots of poems. Then I think 5 or 6 are on Kindle also, on Amazon Kindle. And my latest book, which is, which you have to wait, which I am expecting a Booker's Award. See the confidence I have. Just look at the confidence I have. Booker's Award I'm expecting. अभी publish नहीं हुई है वो. But I'm expecting. So that is the confidence you should have. So that is From Olive Green to a Beauty Queen. That is my latest book. I took 9 years to write that book. It has got 90,000 words in it. And it is with a literary agent. I'm still waiting for Rupa, Hache or Penguin or any other book, big book publishing house should accept it and publish it. And if God willing, I may get an award. I don't know, but I'm hoping. But that will tell you my journey, how I was typically a very masculine, tomboyish lady officer of the Indian Army who converted herself into a beauty queen in the beauty pageants. How difficult it was. It was very difficult for me.
Yeah, actually, that was my next question. So, how you managed to do that? Like, I know the reason why you started. You wanted to get out of that masculine attire and started a journey of womanhood. So what kind of difficulties you faced initially? Like for the first, I think it was a Tanishq crown for you. That was the first pageant show for you, right? And then going on for the Mrs. India and the other crowns. So maybe in a brief, you can explain what were the things you had changed in yourself.
Yeah, see, the way I used to stand, I knew only two poses, Savdhan and Vishram.
So someone is asking, repeat the book name. Someone is asking if you can repeat the book name. So,
what?
Okay, no, sir, there is a comment in which person is asking the book name. So I think it's From Olive Green to Beauty Queen. That is the upcoming book. And before that, you had a book like Essas, and another book was
The Pink Scarecrow.
It was The Pink Scarecrow. That was your first book.
So I told you, the two poses that I knew was Savdhan and Vishram, and every other contestant knew how to do the ramp walk, how to pose, how to wear a short dress, how to apply makeup. So I did not know anything. The way I used to stand, my fist used to close while walking. So the choreographer okay. at Mrs. India choreographer would call me out from the stage. I mean, I was on the stage. He would call me out. Contestant number 5, stop walking like a soldier. For once, please forget you are not a soldier here. You are a beauty queen. So then I would open my palm immediately. But the moment I used to walk ahead, again, it used to be like marching, you know.
So left, right, left. Okay. And like I also, I also like got to know that you were mostly posted since you were in a ordnance regiment. So you mostly had this posting. Like your first posting is very well known to everybody through Google. It was a Siliguri. But apart from that, which was that one posting or maybe I can say one location which changed something in you, like which brought something a big change in your personality or maybe in your own life.
Okay, so my third posting was counterinsurgency area, which is Assam in the northeast. I was the first lady officer to go there. Before me, there was no lady officer posted there because it was not considered safe for women officers. That area was terrorist infested area in the northeast. The Ulfas, which were commonly known as that. And that was a real, real difficult area. Every day, I used to cover myself in a shawl and start from Air Force Station, driving in my car, come to the Army Station, then remove my shawl and then enter the office every day. So that was quite difficult. And it had a lot of problems, lot of issues, it was a very backward place, a small, tiny, underdeveloped place wherein I had to be an officer there and learn a lot. I mean, do a lot and learn a lot. So that was very difficult, but then it was fun. I still miss that.
And there was an incident that was related to Python attack somewhere in the northeast itself. So, if you can tell that in brief, because I am myself is very curious to know how exactly it went.
Oh, okay. That was my first posting. A Python had come in the DSC lines. DSC is a platoon that does the patrolling perimeter security. That takes care of the perimeter security in a depot, in an ordnance depot. So, they are generally retired soldiers, but re-employed in the army as DSC jawans. So they are pretty senior. They are pretty old and senior guys. I was like 23, 24. And I was told that there's a Python over there and he's about to attack. So I took my kinetic Honda and I rushed to the place. See, as a leader, you're supposed to be there to give moral support to your troops. That is the jawans, that is the soldier. So I was there. And I thought, if at least I cannot do anything, I should be there with them to make them feel that they are protected, they are safe. It was middle of the night, 11:30 or 12 o'clock or something. And we didn't have mobiles, we couldn't have communicated. But yes, communication was already sent to the senior officers to send help and all. But I was, till that time, I should be there. So I had almost started my kinetic Honda, reached there, parked my kinetic. Before I could actually be with them, the Python was already out. Before the help would come from the back end, the help was arriving. But before the help could have come, that Python was already out. And I obviously did not know what to do, how to do. But I knew something has to be done. So I stood on top of my kinetic Honda. And I ordered all these soldiers to be in their tents. There was a tent kind of a thing, be inside. And there were a lot of monkeys chattering on the top of the trees. And somehow they were showing a torch and all, danda, torch and everything was there. Somehow a monkey fell. This happened all in a very flash of seconds, actually. Very fast. A monkey fell. And the python attacked that monkey. Now, These soldiers started coming towards this. But then I told them to be there because somehow I could feel if this python will eat the monkey, he will spare any human life. So right. At that time, I had to trade. It was cruel, I know. It was cruel. I mean, I still feel it was cruel to allow him to eat the monkey. But then I couldn't have allowed him to eat any human, actually. Right. So I took charge of that particular situation, and that python was allowed to eat the monkey without disturbing him, without throwing stones or ganda or torch, anything at him. He ate it and then he just zipped from there, his tail hitting my kinetic Honda's rear tire. I was like standing there. So, but then it basically protected the morale of my troops, actually.
Right.
After that, they came out and the help had also come by that time. But then army teaches you to take lead, to take instant decision, and within a disciplined format, you do everything. ऐसा नहीं कि पागल हो जाए, पगला आ जाए बिल्कुल कि हाय हाय क्या होगा, हाय हाय क्या होगा. So everything goes wrong then.
Right, because that's why I think the decision making is one of the OLQ everybody knows who have ever attempted SSB or maybe somewhere related to the procedure. That's why I think for these kind of instances, इंसान को पता होना चाहिए कि कब कैसा decision लेना है. Maybe because few things are out of control for us, we cannot do from our end, but at least we have something in our hand to perform. Correct.
Yeah, everything is in the mind. Army tells you everything is in the mind. Fear is in the mind. Mm-hmm. Your bravery is in the mind. Your decision making is in the mind. So your mind has to be like kept sharp.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So like apart from dancing, like that you have started now. But during army days, everybody have some kind of hobbies. So, you know, जिससे वो अपने आप को कहीं ना कहीं busy रख पाए apart from the job. So what were your hobbies then?
I used to run. I used to enjoy running that time. Running, in any case, was part of the army life only. That was one.
Right.
Then hobby as such, I have never done. I could never sing in my life. That is my regret. Maybe when I'm 70, I'll start learning singing also. Okay. I don't know. So I used to write. I have been always been a writer. So I used to write a lot, and I think. No, that's all. I'm not a foodie, so I never like cooking. I still can't cook very nice.
Okay.
I look forward people to invite me to have me a home cooked food. So and since I'm not a foodie, so I never used to eat so much. So I'm a chai person. Yes, I love chai and biscuits, cookies, something like that. That's it. So in particular, I was not having any hobby, but since I'm a very hardworking person, I always had something or the other to keep myself engaged, keep myself gainfully engaged, I would say. I never wasted my time in my life, actually. I don't know why I didn't waste. I somehow, sometimes I feel I should have wasted some time.
Okay. So like you mentioned, you never wasted. But there would be certain a time, maybe, you know, some good moment or some funny moment ever, maybe in training days or during your postings or maybe with jawans. Or maybe with other colleagues. So that one incident which always makes you feel, oh, that was something rememberable thing. Like,
oh, something. Yes, my first unit, we joined, me and my buddy, my other lady officer, I joined. We were posted in pairs. And that was in Bengdubi. So we went to the tailor. Our seniors took us to the tailor because we have to have a number one uniform. When we join a new unit, the first unit, and we have to meet the commandant of the unit the very next third day or the third, fourth day. So we have to have the number one uniform ready, absolutely brand new. So we were taken to the cant area, and a tailor was there, an old guy. So I was there, and that lady officer was also there. So we went in, and our seniors were outside. Humne bola, aap... टेलर मास्टर जी आप हमारी यूनिफॉर्म सिल दीजिए. सो ही गेव सच अ सरकास्टिक लुक एंड आंसर. बहुत गंदे तरीके उसने हमें झाड़ा. तुम लोग का दिमाग ठीक है? मैं बच्चों के लिए एनसीसी की यूनिफॉर्म नहीं सिलता हूँ. कहाँ से आ गए हो? ही वाज वन ओल्ड मुल्ला जी, एंड आई एम टेलिंग हिम, नहीं हम एनसीसी वाले नहीं है, हम ऑफिसर्स हैं. हम पोस्टेड हुए हैं यहाँ पर। तो कहता है बकवास मत करो, मजाक मत करो, मेरे को बेवकूफ समझा हुआ है, मैंने बोर्ड पे लिखा हुआ है कि ऑल टाइप्स ऑफ यूनिफॉर्म, तो क्या एनसीसी भी लिखा हुआ है मैंने, देखो जरा, मैं नहीं करता, स्कूल के बच्चों के नहीं सिलता, भागो यहाँ से। तो हम बाहर आए, हमने अपने सीनियर्स को बोला, वो तो सुन ही नहीं रहा है टेलर। देन हमारा सीनियर गया एंड ही सेज कि मास्टर जी, ये हमारे ही जैसे ऑफिसर है, ये नए ऑफिसर है, इनकी आप नाप लीजिए। तब भी उसको उसको समझ ही नहीं आया, कहता है ऑफिसर है आप उनकी भेज दीजिए, जो ऑफिसर है उनके नाप भेज दीजिए, मैं यूनिफॉर्म सिल दूंगा। वो बहस ही करता रहा। तब उन्होंने कहा नहीं, ये ही लोग ऑफिसर है, इनकी ही सिलनी है। एंड देन ही रैन इनसाइड और उसके घर में जाके उसने इतनी जोर से बुलाया सबको, आवाज देके, देखो देखो देखो, लड़की लोग ऑफिसर बन गए, लड़की लोग आर्मी में ऑफिसर बन गए। 50 पीपल फ्रॉम हिज पूरा उसका खानदान से आके हम लोग को देखने लगे ऐसे खड़े होके कि हम ऑफिसर हैं, आर्मी ऑफिसर्स हैं, लेडी ऑफिसर्स हैं। दे कुडंट बिलीव। एंड देन दैट टाइम ही वाज सो हैप्पी, ही सेड हम आपकी यूनिफॉर्म जरूर से लेंगे। सो दैट वाज अ वेरी फन इंसिडेंट।
इट वाज गुड, लाइक अदरवाइज कुछ होता कि ऐसे कैसे लड़की ऑफिसर बन गई, ये सब चीजें, मतलब दैट वाज गुड थिंग कि दे एक्सेप्टेड एंड दे लाइक वाओ दे एप्रिशिएटेड दैट बैक।
या एंड ट्रेनिंग के बाद आए थे ना, ट्रेनिंग में आपका मुंह वैसे ही छोटा सा हो जाता है, एंड आई यूज्ड टू लुक वेरी छोटा आल्सो, वी वर जस्ट हार्डली 23-24, और ऐसे ही हम इतने दुबले पतले काले, एकदम बिल्कुल काले काले ट्रेनिंग में धूप में एकदम अपने को, तो वो लगते ही नहीं, बच्चे जैसे ही लग रहे थे हम लोग। और इससे भी एक बहुत मजेदार किस्सा मैं आपको बताऊंगी मेरे जीवन का, जो कि मैं कभी नहीं भूल सकती। एक तो ये था, इसके ठीक 3 महीने बाद मेरे ब्रदर की शादी हुई और हम छुट्टी पे आए अलाहाबाद में, एंड वहाँ मेरे कॉलेज यूनिवर्सिटी के टाइम की साइकिल पड़ी हुई थी। मेरी नानी ने बोला कि एक बिंदी चिपकाने का लिक्विड होता है, उसको लेके आ जाओ बाजार से। तो मैं साइकिल पुरानी उठाई और कटरा मार्केट है इलाहाबाद यूनिवर्सिटी के पास में, मैं वहां पहुंची, साइकिल रखी और दुकान में, सामने ही दुकान थी, सामने ही साइकिल रखी। मैंने बोला बिंदी चिपकाने का लिक्विड दे दीजिए, तो उसने कोई दिखाया नया फेविकोल टाइप का, तो मेरी नानी ने सैंपल दिया था कि ये वाला लाना है। सो आई सेड नहीं नहीं ये नहीं चाहिए, ये वाला चाहिए। सो ही सेड अरे इलाहाबाद कहाँ से कहाँ पहुंच गया, इलाहाबाद की बिटिया आर्मी में ऑफिसर बन गई, तुम हो कि एकदम पुराने जमाने की बातें कर रही हो, थोड़ा बदला करो, देखो इलाहाबाद की लड़की। एंड ही शोड मी द न्यूज़पेपर जिसमें मेरी फोटो छपी हुई है, टेलिंग मी कि इलाहाबाद कहाँ से कहाँ पहुंच गया, इलाहाबाद की बिटिया आर्मी में ऑफिसर बन गई और तुम पुराने जमाने की बात कर रही हो। ही डिड नॉट रिकॉग्नाइज मी, ऑब्वियसली वो मैं यूनिफॉर्म में थी, मैं यहाँ पर एक ऐसे कपड़ों में। मैंने अगेन ही वाज एन ओल्डर गाय, मैंने उसका भरोसा और उसका विश्वास को कायम रखते हुए ऐसे ठीक है, आप वो आप बहुत अच्छी बात कह रहे हैं, वाकई इलाहाबाद चेंज हो गया है, पहली लड़की पहुंच गई, आप मुझे वही दे दीजिए जो आप दे रहे हैं। और मैं चुपचाप लेके उसको साइकिल उठा, और बिल्कुल मेरी साइकिल खटारा साइकिल थी, बिल्कुल वो I didn't want to shock him कि जिस इंसान की तुम फोटो दिखा रहे हो वो मैं ही हूँ। ये इंसिडेंट मैं कभी नहीं भूल पाती हूँ अपना।
Okay, maybe शायद कोई और होता है, just assume कि वो शायद बोल देता है कि just try to recognize me, but maybe आपका केस अलग है, तो there is a good thing also behind that, I would say. Okay. And like I got a question also from few people that the trainings, the hardships you had faced when you were recommissioned as a, like maybe in the third batch, but still it was a very new thing to talk of, like women's in the defense forces. So what were the those different things you inculcated in yourself, like before you went for SSB or for, because I remember at that moment many people would not even know ki kaise jaate hain army mein, army hota kya hai, because 93s 92s was something not everybody was very aware, but I think aapke father was already in defense forces if I'm not wrong, so maybe aapko shayad wahan se idea ho. To apne throughout kaise cheeze matlab ek hota hai na, how you prepared, or maybe you always know ki you will be going to defense forces because tab tak to pata bhi nahi tha ki defense forces mein women hai bhi ki nahi
92 mein actually shuru hua tha army mein induction and main us samay bsc third year mein thi aur maine pass kiya tha I asked my father ki mere ko army mein jana hai my father did not allow me to go unhone bola nahi 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 wahan pe to sirf aise hi le rahe hain glamour ke liye ladkiyon ko lenge koi koi army officers nahi ban sakte ladkiyan and you cannot get selected ye hai wo unhone bahut demotivate kiya but I was very clear so I said mujhko coaching kara do aap kahin pe daudane le chalo aapne to father said no 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 आपको नहीं जाना है समो ही वॉज अगेंस्ट माई ज्वाइनिंग सो मैं सुबह 4 बजे उठ के अपने घर की छत पे अंधेरे में एक आप छत तो जानते हो स्क्वायर होती है सो आई हैव टू रन इन सर्कल इमेजिन एक स्क्वायर छत पे आप सर्कल में दौड़ रहे हो कैसे दौड़ोगे यू हैव टू
ओके दैट टाइम रनिंग वगैरह भी होता है
इमेजिनरी ट्रैक मैंने बनाया एंड आई यूज्ड टू रन ऑन दैट बिकॉज आई वॉन्टेड टू ब्रिंग दैट एजिलिटी इन माई बॉडी कि जिससे मैं जब जाऊं एसएसबी में तो मैं बॉडी में मेरे अंदर एजिलिटी हो सो दैट इज हाउ आई प्रिपेयर्ड मायसेल्फ एवरी डे एंड बुक तो पढ़ते ही थे तैयारी तो करते थे सीडीएस की प्लस माय फादर हैज बीन अ वेरी स्ट्रिक्ट पर्सन यूपी में सभी लड़कियों के उस जमाने में फादर बहुत ही स्ट्रिक्ट होते थे किसी से बात नहीं कर सकते आप किसी से मिल नहीं सकते आपको ये आजादी नहीं आपको वो आजादी नहीं देयर वर हजार तरह की देवर बंदिशें जो कि तोड़ना बहुत मुश्किल था वाकई बहुत मुश्किल था सो आई वाज नॉट अलाउड टू टॉक सो माय फादर ओनली टुक मी टू एसएसबी एंड ही सेड आप किसी से बात नहीं करोगे आप बैठे रहो चुपचाप सो देयर वर गर्ल्स फ्रॉम बिगर सिटीज हु वर देयर टॉकिंग टू एवरीबॉडी और मैं सोचती थी मैं कब ऐसे बात कर पाऊंगी लोगों से ना इनफैक्ट आई डिड नॉट नो हाउ टू स्पीक ऑल्सो आई वॉज अ वेरी डम पर्सन एक्चुअली मुझे आता ही नहीं था बात करना बात कैसे करते बिकॉज माई फादर नेवर अलाउड मी टू स्पीक सो जब एसएसबी का रिजल्ट आया आई वाज द ओनली वन हु गॉट सेलेक्टेड आई वाज सिक्स्थ इन द मेरिट ऑल ओवर इंडिया 25 वैकेंसीज वर देयर एंड आई वाज सिक्स्थ इन द मेरिट एंड जो सारे बाकी थोड़े बड़े शहरों की लड़कियां जो मेरे बैच में थी जो मुझ पर हंस रही थी दे डिडंट गेट सेलेक्टेड तो बाद में वो मेरे को पूछती तुम कैसे हो गए हम तो कभी सोचा नहीं थे कि तुम्हारा होगा so maybe I was very focused maybe I was very focused on my target actually that helps actually that helps in life agar aap daaye baaye nahi dekho ki log kya keh rahe hain aapke bare mein ya log aapke bare mein kya vichar bana rahe if you don't think on that and if you remain focused on your target I think you are going to succeed in your life
right it was so inspiring like If I try to go in that phase, definitely बहुत सारे ऐसे लोग होते हैं जिनको देख के लगता नहीं कि they would do something, you know, exceptional. And you are one among those. So definitely, it creates kind of a history and also motivation for everybody, right? And like about your retirement, like for maybe in civil areas, you started working in SBI Bank, and the changes you felt over there. Apart from the defense life and then your transition to civil person yeah
see SBI mein I am a security officer actually so the nature of the job is almost same every day my dress code is a tucked in full sleeve shirt in a formal trouser with a leather belt with a juda over here my all my fancy hair goes into a juda here and no makeup nothing no lipstick my nails if you can see I don't have long nails still I don't have long nails you can see
so that. During your beauty pageants how you managed like they asked I think they expect such a
I never see all these things I think pata nahi mujhe lagta hai jahan pe aap jao us prakar ke sath aap alignment kar lo wherever you go so organization mein I am a thorough officer there a security officer and I am a no nonsense person I don't talk I maintain one arm distance with all my colleagues I don't cross lines I don't allow people to cross lines also I'm a very strong person that way so my behavior has been my dress code my behavior the way I walk the way I drive everything has given a strong message to everybody in my organization present or that I cannot be taken easily or for granted yes, I'm always open for help. I'm very respectful. I'm very loving. Mm-hmm. But then I will ensure that they remain one arm distant from me. Neither do I go close to them. So that is the way you manage your office relationships. Mm-hmm. And I don't talk like, bad about
during your... Okay, yeah. I think that's the best thing one can do in civil corporate life, because many people are victim of these things. So that's a good thing. Okay. Nice. Somebody has commented that if we can publish this series so that other people can reach out to you and they will be inspired a lot knowing your journey. And yeah, I agree to that.
I'm going to write a book called, no, I've already given the title. It's been copyrighted. Okay. No Woman's Land. I will be writing my journey. Oh. How I crossed each and every obstacle.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Like obstacle about, you mentioned that that duration, there were very few women who were in.
Starting from my class 7th. When I failed in class 7th. That was the time.
Like, in a subject or maybe the whole year?
No, I failed the class only. I couldn't speak English. I couldn't comprehend English. I couldn't understand English. Because I studied in a convent, so I failed in English subject, so they failed me in the class. So I was...
There was a boy who asked me this question. Ma'am, mere ko English nahi aati. I think he's preparing for MBA. And he is always worried about, you know, English. That mere ko English nahi aati hai. Mere ko apne pe... डर लग रहा है कि मैं कैसे आगे प्रोसीड करूंगा. एंड दैट वाज हिज क्वेश्चन आल्सो व्हेन आई आस्क्ड पीपल लाइक ऑडियंस टू यू नो टॉक ऑफ व्हाट काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन यू वांट. सो दैट वाज अ क्वेश्चन. आई थिंक यू आर द राइट पर्सन नाउ.
आई विल आंसर इट. सी, क्या नहीं आता है ये मत सोचो. हैव कॉन्फिडेंस इन योरसेल्फ. हैव पॉजिटिव एटीट्यूड. फिक्स योर टारगेट एंड वर्क ऑन इट. क्या नहीं आता, मेरे को दौड़ना नहीं आता था. व्हेन आई वेंट फॉर माय एसएसबी, मेरे को कूदना नहीं आता था, मगर मैं कूदी. मेरे को टूटा मेरा नाखून, मेरे पैर का नाखून घुस गया, टूटा, ब्लड आया, सब कुछ हुआ, बट हो गया, ठीक है. सो व्हाई डू यू हैव टू वरी सो मच कि मुझे ये नहीं आता, इसकी वजह से क्या होगा. अरे जो होगा देखा जाएगा. लेट मी टेल ऑल द एनडीए और एसएसबी एस्पिरेंट्स, all of them, anybody who's listening to me right now or watching me, if you consider me as successful as Shivangi has brought me out here, the day I had gone for my SSB interview, when the interviewer asked me, how are you? I said, I am Ankita Srivastav. I was so nervous that I could not understand his question. So I was repeatedly speaking in my mind ki mujhe ye bolna hai. But today I'm here in front of you. And I've already publicly told today, and I always tell my flaws. In class 7th I failed because I could not read, write, comprehend English. And if you go today on Amazon or anywhere, you see all my books are in English. And I'm conversing in English as well.
Right, yeah.
Isn't it?
So, that's pretty good.
Don't think kya nahi aata hai. Abhi main bolu, hi, mujhe to dance aata nahi, main kaise seekhu? We come back to the starting point. I could have said this, ki mujhe to aata hi nahi. Maine bola na, gaana maine kabhi nahi gaya hai. But main 70 saal ki age pe shayad seekh lungi.
Correct. That's so, like learning.
Yeah. Don't think kya nahi aata. I've never thought mujhe kya nahi aata hai. Ever since I was in school, I had never thought ki mujhe kya nahi aata hai. Make best use of whatever you have. This is my life mantra. Please make note of all my viewers, all the listeners. Please make best use of whatever resources you have got today. You will be a winner.
Correct. I should have clapped on this part because it actually hits. Can hit everybody, it can hit anyone, like whoever is failing at a point. These lines are kind of a motivation, right? Like, and like you mentioned,
I'm there to motivate. Don't worry, I will motivate everybody, but main danda leke baithungi.
अभी सबको इलाहाबाद भेजना पड़ेगा रिजेक्शन बोर्ड के बाद, सारे आपके घर
मेरे घर भेज दो, तो मैं डंडा लेके बैठूंगी, सबको बोलूंगी चलो मोटिवेट हो. आई विल मोटिवेट. बट सर दीज आर द सिंपल थिंग्स, जस्ट सिंपल थिंग्स. घबराना नहीं है लाइफ में, कभी घबराना नहीं चाहिए, बहादुर होना है, बहुत बहादुर होना है. यू हैव टू बी ब्रेव, थोड़ा बहादुर होना पड़ेगा, रिस्क लेना पड़ेगा.
करेक्ट, रिस्क है तो इश्क है वाला डायलॉग, स्कैम 1990. एंड यू हैव टू सन्स आल्सो, लाइक दे हैव कंप्लीटेड देयर ग्रेजुएशन एंड एवरीथिंग. लाइक आई एम नॉट वेरी श्योर अबाउट देम, आर दे एम्प्लॉयड समवेयर और लाइक स्टिल स्टडीइंग?
They're studying. One is in class 12, one is in college.
Okay.
But they don't want to join Indian Army or Indian Air Force because they have seen me slogging day and night every day. They have never seen me taking rest. They have seen me always running on my toes all the time. So somehow the children saw and they realized ki, no, we don't want to be in this kind of a rut.
Mm-hmm.
And see, it is the DNA. What DNA you have. They have a DNA of a different nature. I had a different nature of, and everybody comes in this world for a different purpose. I had this purpose. I have not forced them, and I'm okay with whatever life they will choose. I'm okay. See, my way is to make them good characters, strong people, happy people. That's
right. So I think that is the one thing very good about today's parenting, like. Parents don't force their children, like, you have to do this, you have to do that. And that is somewhere good also. So, because they get that liberty to choose what they want to do in future.
Yeah.
So, I think that's something good thing. But otherwise, generally, it's a perception that children who have, you know, been to the such cantonment area, such life, because you have covered at least two different forces. So, you could have also expected them to go cover the third perspective, that is the Navy. So maybe that could have been one expectation, but yeah, I think that's also one good option.
They've already seen that life, so now they want to explore something else. I said it's okay.
Correct.
Fine, absolutely.
Right, I agree. And like apart from dancing, what next you are planning to explore? New singing, you have already mentioned you will start by 70s, but before that
What else? I think I just want to motivate people. I'm a speaker. I'm already speak all these things to motivate people. I really enjoy motivating people. If I can motivate one person also, it becomes my happiness. I groom people. I teach them not to keep crying and all those things. I, in fact, want to do a lot for the senior citizens. Like, there are senior citizens post 65 or 60. These people are a bundle of energy, but इनको कहीं utilize नहीं हो रहा है. मैं इन सबको club करके आज के नए generation को moral science के chapter पढ़वाना चाहती हूँ.
अच्छा, like moral science related to ancient history या कुछ और?
Moral science, moral values. जो मैंने school में moral science के chapter पढ़े थे class 1 से. कि thank you बोलना, किसी को किसी की पॉजिटिव चीजें देखना, किसी के अंदर नेगेटिव नहीं देखना, किसी को डाउन नहीं करना, किसी से जेलसी नहीं फील करना. इतना ज्यादा हो गया है हमारी कंट्री में ये सारे नेगेटिव चीजें, बिकॉज कहीं ना कहीं हम लोग मॉरल साइंस के चैप्टर्स अब नहीं पढ़ रहे हैं ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. सो आई वॉन्ट टू यूटिलाइज दिस सीनियर सिटीजन, गिव देम अ टास्क. एक समझ लो आप उधार के नाना नानी या उधार के दादा दादी बना के मैं इनको हर जगह भेजना चाहती हूँ. और आज के जो छोटे बच्चे हैं, छोटे जनरेशन है, इन सबको मैं मॉरल वैल्यू सिखाना चाहती हूँ इनके थ्रू, जिससे ये जो सीनियर सिटीजन है, ये इनको भी, सीनियर सिटीजन भी गेनफुली इंप्लॉय होंगे, कहीं कुछ एंगेज होंगे, दे हैव गॉट सो मच ऑफ नॉलेज. एंड जो नई जनरेशन है, जो हम अभी इस समय डिस्कनेक्ट हो गए, किसी को अभी नाना नानी दादा दादी, मेरे बच्चे भी नहीं बर्दाश्त करते नाना नानी को अपने, बिल्कुल. सो एक हमारे टाइम पे था, मैं पुराना जमाना नहीं कह रही हूँ कि ज्यादा अच्छा था, वो भी खराब थे, उसमें भी बहुत सारी पंगे थे, बहुत पंगे थे. डाउरी डेथ्स हमारे ही जमाने में शुरू हुई थी, सो आई विल नेवर से कि पुराना जमाना अच्छा था, आज का खराब है, सोशल मीडिया है, फलाना ढींग, नथिंग बुलशिट. आई से एवरी जमाना इज गुड, वी आर प्रोग्रेसिंग, बट यस वी कैन लर्न सर्टेन गुड थिंग्स फ्रॉम ईच एरा ऑफ आवर लाइफ.
डेफिनेटली जो ये हमारे ओल्ड एज है या फिर जो हमारे 60s प्लस है, दे हैव दोस थिंग्स जो शायद कहीं ना कहीं डिमिनिश हो रही है विद टाइम. एंड एक टाइम ऐसा रहेगा अगर नाउ वी आर नॉट डेलीगेटिंग इट टुवर्ड्स नेक्स्ट जनरेशन, इट विल बी लॉस्ट समवेयर, दैट कल्चरल वैल्यू ऑल्सो. Right. I agree. Because most of the people debate on this that we are somewhere losing all these things. So I think that's some good take and I would like to be part of that.
And jo aapne bola, abhi maine apna hidden dream to bataya nahi hai abhi aapko.
Okay, and what is that?
Ye chote mote. At the age of 65, I will be the president of India.
Okay, so now you're... venturing into the politics?
No, President of India is not into politics. I'm not saying like, Prime Minister. I said President.
Okay, okay. Okay, I get it.
I will not venture now. After the age of 60, I will start thinking about it. But by the age of 65, I will become the President.
I think that's something you mentioned, confidence. Because had it been somebody else, they would have think, okay, I think there is an issue with that. How can I do this like that? So
why should, that's what that person should say. How can I? I don't know anything about politics. I don't know anything about Rajneeti or anything. But I will be the President of India at the age of 65.
I would wait for that autograph before also.
Maybe before. Yeah, by 60.
Yeah. So nice. And I think there are a lot of things from your childhood till dates. You have ventured a lot, many different obstacles. You have been a pioneer woman, so definitely it was a kind of challenging, but you explored it well. And now again in the civil life, you are taking it well. And also post-retirement, like still you are working. But as a veteran, you have been exploring different things, and especially your writings. They are awesome. I was not very aware of initially, but now I have known. So I'm definitely going to get a read of your book. So I would also ask everyone.
You should read a story of mine. That's a true story. Dreams Undefined is the name of the book. It is a collection of short stories. One of my stories, I'm one of the writer in that. The name of the story is Doordarshan did not sell any dreams, but I still bought one.
I didn't get like.
Okay. Doordarshan, हमारे जमाने में Doordarshan होता था.
Correct.
When I was in class 10th, it was just Doordarshan. Doordarshan ने वो कभी Doordarshan सपने बेचता नहीं था. आज का टीवी सपने बेचता है. मगर मैंने फिर भी खरीदा एक सपना वहां से, और वो सपने का नाम था उड़ान. एक उड़ान सीरियल आता था, उस उड़ान सीरियल ने मेरे को जो सपने दिए, उसकी वजह से ही मैं आर्मी ऑफिसर बनने की मैंने सोचा. यू मस्ट रीड दैट स्टोरी. दूरदर्शन डिड नॉट सेल ड्रीम्स बट आई स्टिल बॉट वन. कैसे कल्याणी सिंह जो सीरियल की मेन आईपीएस ऑफिसर थी, मेरे अंदर घुस चुकी थी, दिन रात मैं उसको ही जीती थी. सो द वे शी यूज्ड टू वेयर हर बेल्ट, द वे शी यूज्ड टू वेयर हर कैप, आई यूज्ड टू जस्ट कीप कॉपिंग इन माय ड्रीम, इन माय नाइट, इन माय डे, एवरी टाइम. एंड एग्जैक्टली फ्यू इयर्स लेटर आई वाज आल्सो डूइंग द सेम थिंग.
दैट वाज काइंड ऑफ अ inspiration you get from, like, that serial. I understand. I am out of words now. If you have anything from your end to talk of, I'm happy to listen to that.
You tell. I will keep on speaking, will get bored.
No, I am not bored at all. I am so very happy to know everything about you. your training life, your postings, because having those 14 years at that initial years, which was not commissioned then. So the moment, it's a good question now coming up. So the moment you all get to know that the permanent commission has been granted, like the short service basically has been extended for women's, and so what was that kind of feeling and how you all celebrated then?
Okay. So now let me tell you. Initially, we were inducted for 5 years. Correct. I was inducted for 5 years. It was because we performed exceptionally well. It was extended from 5 to 10 years. Then once it was 10 years, that was the time. Air Force and Navy, they had given 15 years, but Army had not agreed to give it for 15 years. So all of us were being sent home at the end of 10th year of service. But I again did not give up, and I ran from pillar to post to get it made from 10 to 14 years. So, I met many officers, many bureaucrats. We requested. I just put my point across to the then Defense Minister, Mr. I think George Fernandez. I met him. That if Air Force and Navy can give 15 years to the lady officers, tenure, why can't Army give?
Sorry.
That was very simple logic. So that was the time we had already lost 2 batches. First and second batch had already gone home in the 10th year of service. But mine batch was the 3rd batch, and I could convince the right people, I could put up my case, and I could speak on behalf of all the lady officers, which convinced ultimately, and that got signed, and that is how my batch was saved. We did 14 years, but later on, once I finished 14 years, I lost again this whole battle, because the permanent commission had not been yet granted. Yes. Army was not ready to give. The case had gone, there was a court case, and it was subject to the court. I think from 2004, 2008, the fight in the court had started. 2008, I finished 14 years. That was the time when we started the fight. Imagine how many years, almost 17, 18 years. 12, 13 years. And today, last year, we have won from Supreme Court.
Correct.
So, I can't go back now, though I would love to. I would want to go back and I want to wear my uniform back. But then, yes, I'm happy for the future generations that now they are at least eligible for permanent commission. If they are not fit, they will not be getting. But at least there is an option. In my time, there was no option given to us. It was just not, it was like not given. But then it's okay. See, God has decided what you have to do. You have to do this. But then you have to do something else.
Because you were at least the lucky one who got into forces, because there would be many women before 1992 who never thought of joining defense because there was an option. There was no option for joining that. You were among those batches. At least those get the extension of services. That is also something to be cherished upon maybe in a later days.
Yes. Right. Very true.
Because extension was like you are getting to be retired and then you got to know, okay, this application has been approved and again 4 or 5 years more to go. So that was something. So all your batches, women were there who supported you in their system, or there was few women also who were not agreed to this. Was there any case like that?
We were 25 of lady officers who could who were joined initially, but only I think 4 of us could do 14 years. Beech mein people got married, had children, they didn't get posting with their husband, they didn't have somebody to take care of their children. So because of those many issues, because life in the army is very tough, you cannot actually manage without a support. I was very lucky. My nani ji was there. She took care of my children. So that is how I could manage to continue till 14 years. Otherwise, it's very difficult because you are in the prime of your biological clock, you'll be getting married,
correct.
You'll be delivering your children, you'll have to take care of young children. So it's a very difficult job. It's not so easy.
Correct.
You have to really manage. I mean, I never gave any time to myself. Whatever time I had in my hand, either it was for my army or for my children. Whatever little time I used to come home, not even take off my, I just would take off my belt and bas jameen mein ghoda ban jana, bachcho ko peak pe bekhana, ghoda ghoda khelna. I mean, these were all part of life. और बहुत बहुत तरीकों से आपने बच्चों को मतलब छोटे छोटे नोट्स बना के रखना, दरवाजे पे चिपकाना कि बच्चे के टिफिन में देना क्या है. आई यूज टू फॉरगेट बिकॉज आई डिड नॉट नो हाउ टू बी अ गुड मॉम एक्चुअली. सो आई वुड ऑलवेज पेस्ट स्टिकर्स ऑल अराउंड इन माय हाउस कि आज उसको ऑरेंज फ्रूट देना है, तो आज उसको ये देना है, तो अब उसको फैंसी ड्रेस में ये लाना है, उसका ये. So everything you have to manage, so many things, chota chota things,
no? No, but at least right, but at least you are the mom who most of this like children inspire, like we have such a strong woman in a house. That's kind of feeling they would always, you know, feel grateful.
No. My to children used to call me, they don't have a mother. They used to say, we have two dads. they never thought that I'm a mom. They thought I'm a dad only.
Okay, now you may tell that now I know girls dancing, I know walk. Now what else you required in a woman? You can put a question to
now
that.
Now do they know? Now their girlfriends love me more than them. I'm bindas, I make them enjoy a lot. See, life is not all about positive things. Life is full of negative things. Life is full of challenges. Life does have negative aspects also. But only thing, you don't have to give up. I do fight challenges. Even today I fight my challenges. Even today I really, my life is like every day I get up in the morning, wear my armor, go to the battlefield. I come home after losing that battle, sleep off, again wear my armor in the morning, again go to the battlefield, again lose and again come back. Life is like this for me. But then I will keep going to the battlefield, keep going. I may keep losing, but then I will not stop going.
So you and your husband were like in different forces, so must be having different posting at a time. So, and your children will be your grandnanny, right? Right.
No, I was very lucky. I was very lucky to be posted together because we used to ask for very lousy places. We never asked metro stations, bigger stations. We asked, give us as far as possible in the far east, anywhere you send us, but keep us together. That my priorities were very clear in my life, that I have to be together with the family because that was important too.
Well, that was great that both the forces has, you know, supported the couples also.
Yeah, and one more thing I would like to tell you here. At one stage in life, for all working women, I would tell you, for all strong, independent working women, I would like to tell you, see, there is no competition between husband and wife. कि मैं तुमसे ज्यादा अच्छी हूँ, काम कर रही हूँ या ज्यादा कमा रही हूँ या तुम्हारे बराबर का कर रही हूँ, सो दीज आर नॉट माई जॉब. या एट सम स्टेज एज अ प्रूडेंट इंडिविजुअल, या तो हस्बैंड करे या वाइफ करे, हम दोनों में से किसी एक को नीचे उतरना ही पड़ता है. हम दोनों एक साथ एक सीढ़ी पे नहीं चढ़ सकते. एक सीढ़ी पे अगर हम चढ़ने लगे तो कबाड़ा हो जाएगा घर का, फिर घर नहीं बन पाएगा. इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट. सो वी मस्ट बी रेडी टू स्टेप डाउन कहीं ना कहीं. जैसे माधुरी दीक्षित उस लेवल पे पहुंच के शी स्टेप डाउन, सिमिलरली I also had to step down. I have no regrets. अगर कहीं ना कहीं हम नहीं रुकेंगे, हम नहीं उतरेंगे नीचे, दोनों जन सीढ़ी एक साथ नहीं चढ़ सकते, ऊपर क्लाइंब नहीं कर सकते, प्रमोशन की, करियर की. यू हैव टू स्टेप डाउन. वन ऑफ अस हैव टू स्टेप डाउन, हूएवर डिसाइड्स, मतलब जो करे. इट्स नॉट दैट आई एम सेइंग कि वुमन को करना है. इफ अ मैन इज नॉट एबल टू डू इट, देन द वुमन. And if the woman is not able to do, then the man has to. तभी जाके आपके बच्चे as a working couple के बच्चे तभी थोड़ा सा उनको एक आप समय दे पाओगे. समय, that's it.
Yeah, because in your case it was not dependent on you because you didn't get the extension. Even then you were still working. So it was never like that, that it was dependent on a woman to step down. So it was a mutual thing, I would say, right?
Yeah. So I could have gone to a corporate. I was to join as a, I think, VP. As a VP in some big company in Piramal Glassware or something as a vice president. But then I realized that will be a very demanding job. I will be taking care of so many people under me. I have to be all the time out. I would be traveling. I said, no, I will rather join State Bank of India, wherein I can have time and freedom to attend parent teachers meeting of my children.
Correct. I understand. I just put the charger on. I think battery is running out.
Okay, chalo, we'll wind up then.
Okay, sure, ma'am. Oh, sure. And it was great speaking to you, and I will share this thing. And we have awesome host also, Vijay Nair sir. Hi, sir.
Thanks a lot.
I would say sir was one of the person who has initially mentored me. Like, I was not ready to take this thing, the live session, but he somewhere said that you just need something in your mind and you can start off. And that's why I'm here with you also today.
I'm so glad and that you spotted me.
No, ma'am, it's my pleasure from my end. Thanks, sir. Okay, ma'am, so we'll wind up, and it was great talking to you about your journey.
Thank you so much. Can you send me the recording of this?
Yes, ma'am, for sure, I'll share.
And whenever the whenever this pandemic is over, you can call me for a live session for motivating anybody. Let me clear you right now. I don't charge anything. I do it for free. This is from my heart. This is what I can give back to my society. I just can give back to my society. If I
We do have many comments. Right. We have many comments that they would they will look forward to you again. So I would be happy to host you again.
A live session would be much more entertaining and engaging. People will see me speak, and the body language, they will really enjoy listening to me. And I'm sure it will be
interesting.
You organize that, I'll be there for you.
Okay, for sure, ma'am. I would be happy to do so. So, yes, ma'am?
Thank you. God bless you, Shivangi. Bye-bye.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Bye.